Hello and welcome back, everyone. Trevor here, and today I will be talking a little bit about how stocks and the stock market works. So first of all, you may be asking, what exactly are stocks? Well, that's a good question, and stocks, otherwise known as common shares, are forms of ownership in a public company. It is very important to distinguish these common shares from preferred shares, since the two are different and have different attributes. And in this video, I will be talking specifically about common shares. Now, these common shares grant the owner part ownership in the respective company relative to the total amount of shares outstanding. So, for example, there are 4.6 billion Apple shares outstanding at the moment, and if you were to have one Apple share, that would mean you would have a 4.6 billionth ownership stake in Apple. Now, as an owner, you're entitled to reap the rewards of the company's future business dealings. And this is very important, since having these shares and stocks grant you some fundamental rights as a shareholder. Now, I will be talking specifically about the fundamental shareholder rights in Canada and the US here. So if you happen to be in a different country, you can look it up online and you will find out for yourself. Though, worldwide, they tend to be more or less the same. So anyways, in Canada, shareholders have three fundamental rights. First of all, you have the right to vote at any shareholder meeting. Second of all, you have the right to receive any dividend declared by the board of directors. And third, you have the right to receive any remaining property of the corporation after dissolution. In America, you have six fundamental rights, which are voting power on major issues, ownership in a portion of the company, right to transfer ownership, entitlement to dividends, opportunity to inspect corporate books and records, and the right to sue for wrongful acts. Now, in some cases, a company might decide to have different classes of shares which do carry different rights. The most common of which is to have a class of shares which has limited or no voting rights. Now, these are most common among newer tech companies, which the original owner has decided to limit the voting rights in order for them to maintain opportunity and the power to make the big decisions themselves. And if a company chooses to do so, they must declare it and make it known that this class of shares has this right, these rights, and that this class of shares might have a different set of rights. So that wraps it up for the ownership section of the stocks and shares, so let's move on to the next point. Now that we know what stocks are, let's look at exactly where you can find them. And the answer is, in most cases, on a stock exchange, which is a marketplace where a whole bunch of different stocks are listed, where the public can buy and sell as they choose. And common examples of stock exchanges include the New York Stock Exchange, the NASDAQ, the London Stock Exchange, and the Toronto Stock Exchange, although there exist many, many more across the world. Every company's stock has a unique ticker symbol, which is used to identify it among all the different other companies in an exchange. And the exchanges themselves have unique ticker symbols, which often accompanies a company's ticker symbol in order to identify which stocks are on which exchange. In most cases, these stocks are only listed on a single exchange, though a company might decide to list them on multiple if they, for whatever reason, wish to, let's say, attract more investors from a certain country, or maybe they have very, very large operations in a separate country, which might be some reasons as to why a company might do a list on multiple exchanges. Now, stock exchanges are not the only way to buy and sell stocks. Some stocks are found what's called over-the-counter, which means they are traded without the use of an exchange. Most often, stocks that are traded over-the-counter are stocks that have not met the minimum requirements to be able to be listed on an exchange. So, most often, these stocks will be very, very small, and what are called penny stocks that are often listed under a dollar. And that wraps it up for where exactly you can find these stocks. Now on to an interesting point that I'm sure you guys will be very interested in, which is how exactly do you make money with stocks? Well, the first option is capital gains, which is when the value of your stock goes up, aka the stock price, at which point you could sell and make a profit. Now, while this sounds straightforward and easy, A company stock is never guaranteed to go up, so you should always do your homework and make sure that you're confident that a company will do well in the future and its stock price will go up, although there are never, ever a sure thing. And the second option would be dividends, which is when a company distributes part of its earnings to its shareholders. Now, the exact amount is decided by the board of directors, and if you look online, you can usually find what the normal dividend yield for a specific stock is, which is exactly how much of a dividend relative to the stock price is given out every so often that the company decides. Now, there are other possible alternatives to also make money, though they are a bit more complicated and are recommended for those with a bit more expertise, which are short selling and options, just to name a couple. Now, this wraps it up for how to make money, and let's move on to the next point. Now, finally, let's look at exactly you go about purchasing some stocks. Now, what you are going to need is a trading account with a brokerage. Brokerages are often part of large banks, for example, though there also exist some independent and smaller brokerages that you can find if you look online. These brokerages do change from country to country, so if there is a particular brokerage available in a different country, it will not be available in yours, and you should always look to find the brokerage that fits your needs best within your country, and there are helpful articles and helpful information online for you to find which brokerages are available in your country. Once you open one of these accounts, you are able to trade as freely as you like with using either your cash or what's called margin, which you should look into if you are interested, since it does have the potential to give you high returns, though there does carry some extra risk. Now, once you open one of these accounts, you're free to trade either using your cash or what's called margin. If you are interested in margin, you should be aware that while it does offer the potential to give you high returns, there also is some increased risk if your investments do turn bad. Now, when you do buy and sell a stock, you are often charged a commission, which does vary from brokerage to brokerage, and this information will be available when you look into opening an account. Or even online, someone might have already organized a different comparison with different commissions for brokerages that are available in your region, country, whatever it may be. And it should be noted that smaller brokerages often charge smaller commissions, though they don't always have the same features as bigger banks, for example. And in some cases, you may even be able to find brokerages that offer zero commission trading. You should also look into what features, researchability and quality of platform that a different broker may offer. So obviously these differ from broker to broker, and to be honest, most of the time the higher the commissions, the more features, etc. are available, though you should always think to yourself, what do you need, and maybe look at where the happy medium lies. If you are looking to trade, it is very important that you be 18 plus if you are in the US or Canada, since if you are under this age, you will be unable to trade. And if you happen to live in a different country, I would encourage you to go look online to find exactly what is the age that you can legally trade in your country. So that'll do it for today, guys. Thank you once again for watching. If you like the video, please leave a like. If you have something to say, feel free to leave a comment and let me know down below. Feel free to subscribe and ring that notification bell if you'd like to be noticed instantly when I post next. Once again, thank you for watching, guys.